Hello friends, this is Shefali Rahul Ghutke, currently working as an assistant professor in civil engineering department at Tulsi Ramji Gaikwad Patil College of Engineering and Technology, accredited with NAC A+ grade. I welcome you all in today's Fluid Mechanics 2 lecture. In today's lecture, we will going to discuss about centrifugal pump. So the centrifugal pump is used to convert the mechanical energy into the hydraulic energy, or we can say that into the pressure energy, by the virtue of centrifugal force which is developed inside the casing. Basically, the flow is in radial outward direction. Centrifugal pump works on the principle of forced vortex flow. The common uses of centrifugal pump includes water, sewage, petroleum and petrochemical pumping. Principle: centrifugal pump works on the principle of forced vortex flow, means when a certain mass of a fluid is rotated by the external torque which rises the pressure head inside the casing that takes place. The conversion of energy by the virtue of two main parts of the pump. First one is impeller and the second one is casing. Basically, the impeller which is placed inside the casing converts the driver energy into the kinetic energy, and the diffuser which is present also present inside the casing converts the kinetic energy into the pressure energy. So these are the main components of centrifugal pump, that includes the impeller, casing, suction pipe, foot valve and strainer, and delivery pipe. As you can see in this picture, inside the casing, this is the impeller in which guide vanes are placed. As you can see, the area of centrifugal pump is gradually increasing. This is the volute casing, this is the impeller, and this is the eye of the impeller, or we can say that the suction eye. This is the actual view of centrifugal pump. This is how the centrifugal pump look like. This is the suction side, okay? This is the upstream pipe flange, and this is the impeller, okay? This is the closed impeller. Between these two plates, there are the guide vanes, okay? And this is the volute chamber. Here, the pressure is created into the water, and the water will deliver through the delivery pipe. See, the centrifugal pump has two main components. First one is a rotating component which comprised of an impeller and a shaft. Second one is a stationary component which comprised of a casing, casing cover and bearings. Rotating components. Impeller. The impeller is the main rotating part that provides the centrifugal acceleration to the fluids. Shaft. Its purpose is to transmit the torque encountered when the starting and during the operation, which supports the impeller and the other rotating parts. Basically, the impeller placed inside the casing where the centrifugal pump is created. Because of the centrifugal pump, the water will flow in outward radial direction. Because of the cross-sectional area of the casing, the kinetic energy of a water will convert into the pressure energy. Because of the pressure energy, the water will rise and it transfer into the delivery pipe. Stationary components. Casing. The main purpose of the casing is to convert the kinetic energy into the pressure energy. The casing are of three types. First one is volute, which is used for higher head, where the eddy currents are formed. Second one is vortex, eddy currents are reduced. And the third one is a volute. A volute is a curved funnel which increasing in area to the discharge port. As the area of the cross section increases, the volute reduces the speed of the liquid and increases the pressure of the liquid. Vortex casing. A circular chamber is introduced between a casing and an impeller. The efficiency of the pump is increased because of the vortex casing. The efficiency of a pump will automatically increase. After that, the circular casing have a stationary diffusion vents which surrounding the impeller periphery that converts the velocity energy into the pressure energy. Conventionally, the diffuser are applied to the multi-stage pumps. So, this is the vortex casing. As you can see in this picture, this is the vortex casing which is placed between the impeller and the volute casing. So, in this casing, an annular space known as a vortex or whirlpool chamber is provided between the impeller and the volute casing. The liquid from the impeller flows with a free vortex motion in the vortex chamber, where its velocity converted into the pressure energy. It is more efficient than a volute casing. If we provide the vortex casing in that condition, the efficiency of a pump will automatically increase. Second one is diffuser casing. In this casing, the guide vents are arranged at the outlet of the impeller. As you can see in this picture, these are the guide vents. Okay, so these are the guide vents which are arranged at the outlet of the impeller. This is the impeller. At the outlet of the impeller, here the guide vents are provided. So basically, the guide vents are shaped to provide the gradually enlarged passage for the flow of a fluid, so that the kinetic energy of a liquid which is coming out from the impeller is converted into the pressure energy during the flow in the guide vents. As you can see, the area is continuously increasing, so ultimately the pressure will increase. Then according to the deposition of the shaft, the pump are classified as horizontal pump and the vertical pump. Basically, in horizontal pump, the impeller shaft is used as vertical. So this is the shaft. As you can see, the shaft is placed in horizontal direction. And in vertical pump, the shaft is used in vertical direction. So always remember, before the starting of a centrifugal pump, the priming is very necessary. Basically, it is the process of filling the suction pipe, casing and the delivery pipe up to the delivery valve with the water, so that the air pockets which presents inside the casing, that will remove, so the efficiency of a pump will not get effect. So the priming is used to remove the air from the parts. It is of a two type, positive priming and negative priming. Positive priming is the one which speed up the process, and the negative priming, it is the one which slow down the process of a working of a pump. So basically, how do centrifugal pump work? Basically, the liquid forced into the impeller, the vents passes the kinetic energy to the liquid so that the liquid rotates and leaves the impeller. The volute casing will convert the kinetic energy into the pressure energy. So this is the eye of the impeller, this is the inlet, or we can say that this is the suction pipe. So the water will come from the suction pipe, and which the water will rotate inside the casing, where the kinetic energy of a water will change into the pressure energy. After that, the water will leaves the centrifugal pump and it travels from the delivery pipe. So it consists of an impeller rotating within a casing. See, the liquid directed into the center of the rotating impeller is picked up by the impeller vents and accelerated to a higher velocity by the rotation of the impeller and discharged by centrifugal force into the casing. So basically, this is the water which goes from the eye of the impeller, and see, this is the impeller and this is the direction of a water. As you can see, the water is travel in radial outward direction. Here the centrifugal force is created. So this is the velocity triangle we already studied in fluid mechanics 1 in impact of jet chapter, that the velocity triangles are created with the help of different vanes. Okay, if the vanes placed vertically, if the vanes placed horizontal, if there is a curved vane, so depends on the different types of a vane or depends on the position of a vane, the velocity triangle diagram will get changed. So we draw the velocity triangle diagram at the inlet of the vane and at the outlet of the vane. So as you can see, these are the different types of a vanes. The first one is forward facing vane, in which the angle is greater than 90 degree. This is the radial vane, where the angle is 90 degree, and this is the backward facing vane, where the angle is less than 90 degree. Okay, so this is the curved vane in which the velocity triangle is drawn at the inlet, and this is the outlet. Okay, so the velocity triangle will draw at the inlet and the outlet of the vane. Okay, so basically the work done by the impeller on the water will be calculated as capital W is equal to VW2 U2 minus VW1 U1 divided by G. So this W is nothing but work done per unit weight of a water per second. This VW2 is real component of absolute velocity of the jet at the outlet. And this capital U2 is nothing but the tangential velocity of the impeller at the outlet. This VW1 is nothing but the real component of the absolute velocity of the jet at the inlet. And this U1 is nothing but the tangential velocity of the impeller at the inlet. So the velocity will vary at the inlet and the outlet of the vane. So if the water comes in radial direction, so in that case the guide blade angle will be equal to 90 degree. In that case the real velocity at inlet will be equal to zero. So the work done by the impeller will be equal to VW2 into U2 divided by G. So there are different types of heads in centrifugal pump. First one is suction head, second one is delivery head, and the third one is static head. Suction head. So as you can see in this picture, this is the suction head, this is the delivery head, and this one is the total head. Okay, so basically the suction head, it is the vertical height of the center line of a centrifugal pump above the water surface to the pump from which the water to be lifted. As you can see in this picture, this is the suction head. It is the vertical distance between the center of the eye of the impeller to the point where the water is lifted, from where the water is lifted. Okay, and this is the delivery head. So the delivery head, it is a vertical distance between the center line of the pump and the water surface in the tank to which the water is delivered. Then the second one is static head. It means the total head. It is the sum of suction head and the delivery head. Fourth one is manometric head. The head against which a centrifugal pump has to work, which is represented by HM, which is equal to HS plus HD plus HFS plus HFD plus VD square by 2G. So this is the centrifugal pump. As you can see, at the bottom of the suction pipe there is a foot wall and the strainer. The water is lift, or we can say the water is sucked from the suction pipe. At the bottom of the suction pipe there is a foot wall and the strainer. So this is the foot wall is a non-return valve. Okay, it means there is a no possibility of a backward flow of a water, and the strainer is provided so that the debris will not enter into the pump. So if the water is travel from the suction pipe, it will come from the eye of the impeller and it will rotate inside the casing. Here because of the impeller there is a centrifugal force is generated. Okay, as the water is travel from this side to this side. Here you can see the area is very small. So in that case, the velocity of a water is more as compared to the pressure energy. As the water is travel from this direction, as you can see, the area is increased. As the area increased, in that case, the pressure of a water will get increased. Or you can say that the area of a suction pipe is less and the area of delivery pipe is more. Why so? Because the pressure energy of a water will increase. So the water will automatically deliver up to the delivery tank. And here the delivery valve is provided. This is also a non-return valve. There is no possibility of a backward flow of a water. Okay. So these are the efficiencies of a centrifugal pump. First one is manometric efficiency. Manometric efficiency, it is the ratio of manometric head, which is represented by HM, to the head imparted by the impeller. And the mechanical efficiency, it is the ratio of a power which is delivered by the impeller to the power input to the shaft. So the formula will be like this for the mechanical efficiency. Next one is overall efficiency. Overall efficiency, it is nothing but the ratio of power output of the pump to the power input to the pump or the shaft. Efficiency is nothing but it is the ratio of output divided by input. So power will be output and the input will be power input to the pump or the shaft. Okay, so the formula will become WHM divided by P. Multi-stage centrifugal pump. It consists of two or more impeller. If suppose there are two or more impeller, in that case we can say that this is not a single centrifugal pump. This is a multi-stage centrifugal pump. Basically, there are two types. First one is series, which is used to produce the high head, and the second one is parallel connection, which is used to discharge the large quantity of a liquid. So this is the series combination for high head. As you can see, the impeller are placed in a series. These are the impellers. This is the shaft. This is the shaft and this is the impeller. So as you can see in this picture clearly, this is the shaft. And these are the impellers, okay? These are placed in series for creating the high head. And this is the parallel connection of impeller, which is used to generate the high discharge. Cavitation phenomena. Cavities are formed inside the casing. So basically, what is cavitation? Cavitation is a phenomena of a formation of a vapor bubbles where the pressure of a liquid falls below the vapor pressure of a flowing fluid. So the collapsing of a vapor bubbles causes the high pressure results in the pitting action or the metallic surface. So the erosion, noise and the vibration are produced. Basically, when the water is flowing inside the casing, in that case, the vapor bubbles are formed because of the falling of a pressure energy below the vapor pressure. So these bubbles will travel from one zone, one area to the another area. As they are travel, they collapsed, and because of their collapsing phenomena, high pressure will generate, which ultimately results in pitting action. So because of the pitting action, the noise and vibration are produced. So as you can see in this picture, the cavitation damage has been occurred. This is the high pressure zone and this is the low pressure zone. Because of the cavitation, the impeller, casing and the various part of the centrifugal pump will get damaged. It ultimately reduces the efficiency of the pump. So the effect of the cavitation, metallic surface are damaged and the cavities are formed. Because of the cavitation, the efficiency of the pump will get decreased, unwanted noise and the vibration are produced. So, as you can see, this is the damage which is occurred because of the cavitation, which ultimately reduces the efficiency of the pump. Now, what are the disadvantages of centrifugal pump? For the centrifugal pump, always remember extra priming requires. It cannot be able to work on a high speed, and even the centrifugal pump cannot deal with highly viscous liquid. Now, the centrifugal pump can be used in agriculture and irrigation purpose, which is used centrifugal. In our home, the centrifugal pump are used for lifting the water from the lower level to the higher level, and centrifugal pump are also used to transfer the raw material. So this is all about the centrifugal pump. Thank you.